time. Long time. We shouldn't have left you. Left you. Without a dope beat. Step two. Step two. Step two. Step two. Step step two. Step two. Think it, think it. It's been a long time. Time. We shouldn't have left you. Left you. Without a dope beat. Step two. Step two. Hi guys, and welcome to another episode of Crypto Editor UK. My name is Michael, and as always, we bring you the very latest in price, hype, and speculation in the wonderful world of crypto assets. Now, it has been a long time, well, precisely a week and a half. I'm back, I'm re-energized, bringing you more content. What I wanted to ask you guys is, I mean, just to help with my channel and its growth, please remember to like, share and subscribe, particularly subscribe the channel. There is a lot of work that goes into the research to bring you all the content that we bring, and it would be much appreciated if you could just click that subscribe button for me today. Now, in relation to today's video, we'll be looking at the Bitcoin price with peekaboo above the 10k US dollar mark. We'll move on and we'll also be looking at FUD. It's very important to explain FUD, fear, uncertainty and doubt, what it means and how we can move forward past that in the crypto community presently. And finally, we'll be looking at a few key alternative cryptos or altcoins, as they call them. Have a look at these coins, look at the use cases and look at their partnerships and how they're growing exponentially. So, without any further ado, make sure you like and subscribe again. Let's jump straight into the content right after this. Welcome back, another video, I'm back. So I've just been off, I took a week off. I've taken a week off just to recharge. I was busy with my day job and my career. But it just felt like the right time just to take the foot off the pedal, you know. It was a time where Bitcoin itself, the price was a bit volatile. It had gone down to 8,800 US dollars. Actually, I think a bit lower than that. And generally, the feel in the community was of a bit of fear, uncertainty and doubt, the FUD that I was talking about. And I just thought, this doesn't really resonate with me and this is not really what I want to be consuming at the moment. So a lot of what we do, especially as YouTubers, we're looking at other YouTubers, it's a community, especially with the crypto community. There's a lot of correlation and the market generally just felt, people just felt unhappy. There was all the talk of YouTubers being banned for certain videos, and there was talk of shadow banning and demonetization and all sorts of conspiracies, but again, they're not unfounded. There was a lot of fact in what was going on, but it just felt like a low vibe place to be in. So I thought, let me put my feet up for a week, take a break, focus on other things. But today I'm back, and let's take a look at fear, uncertainty, and doubt, and actually what it means. So here, it does refer to FUD. FUD is generally a strategic attempt to influence perception by disseminating negative and dubious or false information. An individual firm, for example, might use FUD to invite unfavorable opinions and speculation about a competitor's product, to increase the general estimation of switching costs among current customers, or to maintain leverage over a current business partner who could potentially become a rival. So essentially, it's fear porn. And I found that across the whole community, for the last week and a half, 2 weeks, there was a lot of, oh, get your coins off the exchanges. And I understand the whole point of that. There was the, and at the same time, what was happening is people were using that to promote ledgers and cold storage wallets, which they do serve a purpose, but everything was all doom and gloom.
let's look at FUD under security industry and profession. It says FUD is also widely recognized as a tactic used to promote the sale or implementation of security products, again, the Ledger nano wallets and things like that, and measures. While there are many true security threats and breaches, it is possible to find pages describing purely artificial problems. So the reason why I would say that, I'm not saying that it was artificial, and the real threat of, you know, hacks on exchanges is real and on trading platforms is real, but I could see a lot of people pushing Ledger Nano wallets and things like that, and there was a lot of fear about taking your coins off the exchanges. And generally, I mean, that's it. I wanted to explain FUD, and this is one of the reasons, the fear, uncertainty and doubt that wanted me to just move away from the space for a moment. There is generally a lot of fear, uncertainty and doubt across the world for various reasons at the moment. On the date of recording today, which is the 2nd of June, we are, as a global community, in a lot of turmoil at the moment, and without getting into politics and things like that, there are other reasons, you know, FUD is used, and again, it's used a lot in politics. Here it reads, FUD is now often used in non-computer contexts with the same meaning. For example, in politics, one side can accuse the other side of using FUD to obscure the issues. And again, like I've said, at the moment, we are in highly political charged times for various reasons, health, race, things like that. And I think there is a lot of fear, uncertainty and doubt generally in the on the global scale. And it's just being pushed and used in the wrong way. But anyway, enough of that being said, let's jump straight into the Bitcoin price. And as we can see today, as I woke up, I said, oh, what's this? What's this I see? Bitcoin is up 5.89%. And peekaboo, I see you. We are over $10,000. We have reached over that limit, which was holding us back for a bit there. But we've managed to have a pump there overnight. And so it's good news for the community. Hopefully, it will quell some of the FUD that was going around. And so we are currently at the date of recording $10,114, and let's now go to the trading view chart, and I'll explain something here. So as we can see on the trading view chart, I had drawn some lines here which I had seen this as you can see, there was a trend. There was a raise. There is a trending pattern, which is an upward trend. And I had drawn these two lines here. And the reason why I had put these two lines here was to suggest what I thought was going to be a pennant there. So a pennant or flag. So here, as we can see, pennant patterns or flags are created after an asset experiences a period of upward movement, which we have had here. So we've had a period of upward movement since March to today's date. We've had a period of upward movement. And what I'll do is I'll get the, if you can see here, since March, since the bottom there, we have had a 108% increase in the price of Bitcoin. So not too shabby if you ask me. But going back to the bull pennant, so the pennant patterns are created after an asset experiences a period of upward movement, followed by consolidation. So you had our consolidation stage, and as you can see from here, the consolidation pattern now has seen we've broken out of that pennant, and as you can see here, we've gone above the $10,000 mark. So going back to this, generally there will be a significant increase during the early stages of the trend before it enters into a series of smaller upward and downward movements. So going back to UK Trading View, you can see that we had smaller upward and downward movement, and then it broke out to the upside overnight there. So that's where our 5% increase has come from. So wonderful. So that's the Bitcoin price. Things are looking good. Let's turn to some news that's caught my attention in the last week or so. So the question is, what's causing all the price movement? Why have you had such a sudden pump? And here, going to this article on the Daily Hodl, it says here, Bitcoin and Ethereum whales move 313 million in crypto as Ripple unlocks 1 million XRP. So this came, this is an article written on June the 1st on Daily Hodl. So the important part to look out for here is, in an effort to prevent fear, uncertainty and doubt, the very topic of today's video, the bot is designed to ignore internal crypto transfers handled by exchanges. So if two transfers are not BitThumb moving its own assets, there could be a trader or an institution shifting their BTC to a private wallet after a large buy order. So give you a bit of background here. 6,000 BTC worth, which is 140 million from the crypto exchange BitThumb, were moved to from BitThumb to an unknown wallet. So all of this goes to play on the speculation and the speculative nature of crypto assets. And this is not the only time that's been happening recently. So this is something that's been going on in the last couple of months, where we've seen very big moves from exchanges to private wallets. And I suppose this has been something that's been fueling the FUD mentality in the community. So in the last recent months, we've had, you know, here 14.3 million transferred from Binance to OKEx exchange, 27.7 million transferred from BitThumb to an unknown wallet, 14.3 million transferred from OKEx to an unknown wallet, and 33.2 million transferred from an unknown wallet to OKEx. So you can see that there is a lot of activity there in transferring of significant amounts of Bitcoin. This is something that maybe could be suggested to be driving up the price of Bitcoin at the moment. However, as I've stated in my previous videos, I believe that currently the way to check how crypto is moving and to see how the market leader Bitcoin will move is based on Tether, USDT, and the amount that they're printing. So the Treasury is continuously printing or minting new Tether coins there. But also, another announcement, Ripple monthly movement of XRP is underway. The exchange just released 1 billion of its XRP from escrow, making the fund available to sell to institutions and cryptocurrency exchanges. And as we can see here, Whale Alert did put a tweet just to update everybody on that, and that was on June the 1st at 1:03 a.m. So the markets could be playing to what's happening based on all the huge movements in Bitcoin and across exchanges, and also the 1 billion XRP there that's just been released. So that's something to keep an eye on. Moving on, I just wanted to talk about the altcoins, which are also making a bit of a noise at the moment. There's an article here which I've come across. It says four altcoins announced this week in partnership with giant companies. So again, these are alternatives to Bitcoin, which you should definitely be keeping an eye on, because these are going to be making major moves. They are more affordable, and also they will see huge increases in price based on the partnerships that they're making. So let's take a look at which coins are making this noise. Okay, so VeChain, number one, VeChain. So here, as it reads, VeChain has been actively in the cryptocurrency market for nearly 2 years, but it is the cryptocurrency project that has made the most mention of its partnerships, which has previously signed agreements with Walmart, H&M, PricewaterhouseCooper, Bright Foods, and many other important companies, is partnering with Bayer China, the Chinese arm of the world pharmaceutical giant Bayer, according to a recent development. Bayer China is reportedly working with VeChain to develop a new blockchain-based tracking platform. Thanks to the solution developed by the pharmaceutical giant, it aims to monitor the medicines throughout the supply chain. So VeChain there, definitely one to keep on your list and to be aware of. The second one here is Matic. And Matic has been something that's been growing in price and trend off late as well. So in another development announced today, like VeChain, Matic has reached an agreement with the 40 billion Indian technology giant Infosys, listed on the world's largest stock exchange, the New York Stock Exchange. As part of the partnership, the multinational technology company will run a node on the Matic network. In the statement made by Matic, it was noted that Infosys will thus provide a safe and strong platform for Matic's growing dApp ecosystem. We are proud to welcome Infosys as a network verifier, said Matic's co-founder and operations director Sandeep Nawal in a statement on the subject. Infosys is the pioneer of the Indian technological success story and an idol for millions of computer science professionals like me, he said, and expressed his enthusiasm for working with such an iconic institution. So again, another coin to look out for there, which will this type of speculation is very welcome, and we'll see price increases is Matic. The third one here is Theta. So this one was big news very recently. I think they here it's put down, it turned out that the internet giant Google partnered with Theta Labs to help users on the video distribution network via Google Cloud. It is even stated that the company will become the fifth external node of the protocol by stating 5 million Theta tokens, 2.5 million in the network. So again, Theta there working with Google, another big multinational conglomerate there. And finally, Engine Coin here is working with Minecraft. The partnership between Engine and Minecraft is not new, but a development announced yesterday takes this partnership further. According to the statement from Engine, Minecraft, and one of their most popular video games in the world, now has a new plugin that allows players to place blockchain assets directly on their servers. The plugin in question was called EngineCraft and was developed by Engine. The news had a 22% impact on the price of Engine. So there's four altcoins there with giant companies. So again, keep an eye out on those four. Moving on, another one here. So this is a UK-based company. A company close to my heart here in the UK, Electronium. They are to launch electricity top-ups across Africa. So now let's take a look at this. So crypto payments network Electronium takes aim at expanding to African countries with new electricity top-up feature. So the blockchain-based digital payment project Electronium will be launching an in-app electricity top-up feature across the four African countries, Nigeria, Senegal, Mali, and the Gambia. The electricity top-up feature will allow ETN app users to top up their electricity meters directly from the app by paying in ETN tokens. Okay, the ETN mobile application previously added support for airtime and data top-ups across 140 countries worldwide. So again, this is very big news. ETN, I have been receiving emails from their head, which is Richard Ells, and I believe that it's a project well worth looking into. At the moment, ETN is not really worth that much, so definitely have a look at that. They are helping to do something which not only is positive for its use case, but also it's very positive in that it's helping a cause which is, you know, very close to a lot of people's hearts. So definitely have a look at that. And finally, let's look at the last story here, and that is Coinbase. Okay, so I recently had an email from Coinbase. I'm a Coinbase customer. I have bought Tezos, which is a coin on the Coinbase portfolio. And what they've announced is Coinbase has announced that it is to start offering staking rewards to its customers in the UK and certain EU countries. So that affects us guys in the UK, guys. So it's something very key to look at. Cryptocurrency exchanges could use staking to effectively pay their customers interest at more competitive rates than is on offer at traditional banks, and blur the lines between what is a bank and what is not. So this is big major news. Quickly ask the question, what is Tezos and what is staking? Okay, so Tezos is one of the newer crop of cryptocurrencies, having launched in September 2018 after raising $232 million via an ICO. So its network is based on proof of staking protocol, meaning it does not involve the mining work and the huge electricity output involved that other cryptos like Bitcoin are built on. Staking is a process where users hold funds in cryptocurrency wallets to support a blockchain's network's operation. Where most cryptocurrency networks are supported by proof of work, staking relies on proof of stake, allowing blocks to continue to be added without the energy intensive mining. So instead of the users of the network competing to add the next block by solving complex mathematical problems, they are chosen as validator of the next block based on their current stake in the network. Some commentators therefore suggest that POS, or proof of stake, is a more scalable and sustainable model for a blockchain than proof of work because it lacks the burden of excessive electricity use. Okay, so that's essentially what it is. Anybody with Tezos or with a Coinbase account would advise to add some Tezos. It's still currently at a very reasonable price, and you'll be rewarded with a payment of interest on top of what you have staked. Okay, so that's the news for today. Thank you so much for joining me today. I do feel refreshed and energized after a week off. That's what's going on in the wonderful world of crypto. We've peekabooed above the 10k price again. Let's see if we can stay there. Who knows? But we'll be bringing you further and more news. So until then, see you next time.